It's music reaction time!
Hey, today we got something special for y'all. It is a Disney song, but sung with international superstars.
Oh, from?
From, I believe, Indonesia. This was something that was recommended from our viewers. I'm going to try to pronounce their names here. Gamaliél and also Isyana Sarasvati. No idea if it's right or not.
You try
but
your best.
But what's important here is that we recently discovered that Disney, when they launched a movie like Aladdin, which has a lot of musicals worldwide, they actually hire local celebrity singers to sing renditions of these popular songs.
Mm-hmm.
And that's all thanks to us discovering Gam Wichanai, which
right.
is a popular idol from Thailand, singing, you know, Frozen. So we've been catching on to this whole Disney train. It's a whole side of Disney music that we never knew existed before. I'm loving it.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. You could be like so proud knowing that you have representative from your country singing from a famous movie, let's say that way.
Now, I don't know if this particular version of the song, A Whole New World, actually has different phrases in the local language, but we're going to find out for the first time. We haven't seen the new Aladdin movie, and this is where it's from. I'm a bit biased because I love the original cartoon with Robin Williams. Like, nothing's going to top that. That was honestly probably the best Disney animation of that era. So we haven't even gone to see the new movie just yet. But we know it's been top of the charts worldwide, doing really well for a whole new generation of fans.
Uh-huh. Let's enjoy it and taste a different flavor from Indonesia.
Let's. All right, and away we go. So ominous.
I can show you the world. Oh, she's so pretty.
She's like an Asian Disney princess.
Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes.
Wait, his English is perfect.
Take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new world.
He's got a dreamy voice.
A fantastic point of view. No one to tell us no where to go. Oh, say we're only dreaming. A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm way up here, it's crystal clear.
Her English is really quite good too.
Both of them are amazing. I can't hear an accent.
It's like you're lost in a neon lights factory.
It is.
I want to go watch the movie now, baby. I forgot how good this song was.
No, that song is so
makes me fall in love again.
Aren't you tired 10 years?
Sometimes it just takes a song to break you out of that doldrum spell. But I'm back. Don't worry, I'm back. I'm back to reality. What am I? Oh, okay.
I absolutely love their voices.
Yes. Their voices are honestly shockingly good. I mean, just the purity of it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I remember the original song and how those voices are really clear. I mean, it was at a bar that at the time, you just never would have ever heard something like this from a Disney movie.
Also, I love Gamaliel's voice and the part where he did some R&B.
He had like one riff, one deliberately placed riff, and it was, that was a delight.
I was like hooked. That was like, I love
all right, well, as much as you like him, I love the woman.
I love her too.
Isyana, these two nailed it. Mm. I honestly feel like this could have just been the American version.
That's right.
Well, here's something I got, which is a bit of a rant now. Having heard Frozen, that version of the song, where they actually sing certain parts of the song in their native language, this was a straight up all English version of the song. So it would have been nice to actually hear some flavors of their own language in there. Not something that I would have missed. Like, I wouldn't have noticed it if I just watched it. But now having known Disney embraces these other languages, kind of miss the international flavor, if you will.
I have to agree. I thought that they're going to do some, you know, mix of their own language and also sing the English version. All right, our number one, which is the rant. I have something to rant. It's from Aladdin, so it has to have tons of colors, right? With this one, what they did is kind of dark. They're inside of that neon room. I would love to have it on a bright...
Right. You know, like in a desert scene. Something that had more of the flavor from the movie. That's which had a lot of very bright colors from there. I mean, when this first started, I was like, why is this so dark? It's very moody. I thought it was a little even creepy. I don't know. Maybe it was a small budget they had to work with. But even then, I think they could have like just put them into like a neon factory with a lot of different colors, rainbows, if you will.
Right.
But that being said, that doesn't take it away from the performance of these two. It doesn't take it away from the fact that it's an amazing song. And I honestly can't wait to hear more of what they sing now. What has made them so popular? Why were these two chosen? Because clearly, they're the bomb.
Nice voice. Golden voice.